Hello, my name is Stylianos Asimakopoulos, and I'm an Associate Professor of Economics at the University of Bath. This talk is based on a work in progress on the role of ESG on corporate debt structure, which is co-authored with Panagiotis Asimakopoulos from Loughborough University and Xinyu Li from the University of Bath. So why do we focus on the interaction between ESG and debt structure? On the one hand, ESG has received a lot of attention over the past years, and especially during the last 5 years with a non-stopping upward trend. Actually, figure one shows here the number of ESG-rated firms by Refinitiv is always increasing, especially after the Paris Agreement of 2015. Moreover, ESG-rated firms appear to be safer and with lower costs of borrowing in terms of bank loans and bond issuing. On the other hand, debt structure has always been the focal point of corporations. For example, trade-off theory indicates that there exists an optimal level of leverage that the firm converts towards to at a speed of about 1/3 per year. In addition, pecking order theory suggests that firms seek safer sources of financing, starting from internal cash, then bank loans, bond issuing, and equity at the end. Our empirical analysis combines various large databases and is based on more than 2,300 unique US firms for the period 2002 to 2019. We find that when firms become ESG rated by Refinitiv, they reduce their optimal market and book leverage ratio at a magnitude of about 12 to 20%. This happens because ESG-rated firms can attract investors and have higher growth opportunities. Therefore, they want to limit their borrowing and avoid any underinvestment issues that arise from high leverage. We further find that the current overall borrowing position of the firm remains unaffected. We further find that the ESG issuing conveys significant information to the market, like lenders and investors, helping the ESG rated firms reduce their asymmetric information issues. Most importantly, we saw that when firms become ESG rated, they can turn towards safer or more internal sources of financing. Therefore, they restructure their debt by substituting their financing position away from bond issuing towards bank loans. These results follow from the lower asymmetric information due to the ESG disclosure that reduces the cost of borrowing. These results are more pronounced for firms that are under high financial pressure and for firms with high ESG ratings. Thank you very much.